What's your prediction for the Area 51 raid? A dozen people show up, stare awkwardly at one another in the middle of the desert without speaking for several minutes. They sit, hope more show up. One checks Pokemon Go. Eventually, they gain enough confidence to break the ice. They go back home and create some dope memes for the rest of us that were just playing along with the joke. Plot twist, you can catch Elgium, Bahium in the desert around Area 51, if you can get cell service. The army will be forced to set out an aid station with water and sunscreen, because, of course, no one brought nearly enough. 50 Nevada National Guard medics hand out sunscreen to idiots. Bunch of food trucks and $7 bottled water sellers show up. 150 people also show up, eat and leave. And then it happens every year cause it's so fun. A few years down the road it becomes a new alien slash space themed music festival called the Hitchhiker's Guide to Music Festivals, and it'll all be so fun that aliens will start showing up but no one will believe that they're aliens cause everyone's tripping already. If it actually happened, the military has a great opportunity to test new crowd dispersal technology and non-lethal weapons. Conspiracy theory, this whole event was set up by the military to test their new crowd dispersal technology and non-lethal weapons. I feel like there are better places they could easily test this. 12 lonely people who are gonna stand out there, get ready, and then not. Government's gonna have to waste a lot of money on prepping for an actual event, though. The people are gonna be warned they can be legally shot if they enter and storm, and then they back off. B. They enter and get killed. C. They discover the minefield. D. The 2nd Furry Division sets up a PR0N show for the guards. And then the 4th Weebs and 1st Gamer Divisions rush in from the other side, and the 3rd Normie Division knocks out the guards that the furries have distracted. Approximate numbers for the People's Army. Edited. 1st Gamers. 190k. 2nd Furries. 45k. 3rd Normies. 212k. 4th Weebs. 213k. SHHH, stop talking about our secret forces. These are approximations. Much potential to grow. 97% of the folks who've said they were going won't attend. The remaining 3% will cancel due to lack of numbers. I really want 300,000 people to show up. I'm going to be honest. So do I. Deep down I think it would be fun to see what happens, as long as everyone isn't brutally murdered. Well, I mean, even then, a little Boston Massacre action never really hurt anyone. 10 people actually show up, and they are told to go away. They go away, the end. But not before we are tormented for the next few months with Area 51 memes. I doubt Area 51 memes will actually live as long as a few months. I predict that they'll die on Reddit within several days, live on another social media for a little while, and then die. However, a brief revival of the meme will occur in the days leading up to and after September 20th. The few people who actually decide to show will get disheartened once they realize just how remote the extraterrestrial highway is, and how many hours of sagebrush they'll have to drive through to walk up to a perimeter fence and be stopped by authorities who stop everyone who even pulls over to pee remotely close to Area 51. Crazies regularly try to get onto Area 51. The government has experience dealing with this. Or the government will just shut down the extraterrestrial highway for a while if they think it'll be a big deal. It's not like there are a lot of ways to access Area 51. It's a game people play out there. Drive up to the sign. Wait for the white SUV to suddenly come driving down the hill towards you, then turn around and hightail it out of there. Gives those Air Force security guys a little break in the monotony. Is it illegal to just stand in front of the sign without crossing it? I'm imagining a bunch of AMI being detained. People would demonstrably lean over the line as far as they can and dare the military to do something. They change the address on Google the night before, so we all turn up at the wrong place. 15 people show up and are detained within minutes. Let's just say a few thousand idiots manage to show up and think they can pull it off. Best case scenario, they make a run for the fence line. The base responds with an acoustic non-lethal device. Roughly 1/3 of the group goes down, clutching their ears. Many more go down as they get closer, determined to make the fence but ultimately failing. So maybe low four-figure number actually make it within a few hundred yards of the fence line, in a significantly degraded state from a single non-lethal device. Cue the riot agents. A volley of tear gas canisters turns the last 5 football fields of distance to the fence line into a densely fogged snot fest. Another 50-60% become combat ineffective. Between the ringing in their ears, their inability to breathe, and the inability to see through the fog of gas, most of the group is unwilling or unable to proceed. A small number of intrepid individuals make it within 100 yards of the fence line. The searchlights come on. Between the fog, the tears, and millions of lumens of light in their face, they can't see what the hell is going on. They shout directions at one another, but now they're only a few hundred yards from the acoustic devices, and nobody can hear shit. Except for the first salvo of warning shots from a 50 caliber HMG mounted to a Humvee nearby. Most of them scatter. A couple of brave souls aren't intimidated by the warning shots. By sheer dumb luck, they get to the fence line and pull out the wire cutters. One shouts, "We did it, Reddit," just before being turned into a fine pink mist by the 50s. On the base side, most of the 20 people required to actually repel this attack go back to the cafeteria laughing about it. The .50 gunner gets sent home, then to critical incident counseling. The other hundreds of guys who were on call up bitch that the morons didn't even break through the fence and trigger a real response, and that they wasted their night for nothing. Worst case scenario, some idiot or group of idiots in the crowd produces a firearm, and they manage to put effective fire on some of the guards. The guards respond in accordance with the row issued to them, defend the facility with reasonable force, up to and including deadly force if required. Simultaneously, several Humvees open up with .50 calories and 7.62mm machine gun fire. Along with whoever produced a firearm, hundreds of people who thought they were badass a few minutes ago are now casualties, lying on the ground wailing. Most people scatter, but more gunshots are heard from the crowd, each met with a burst of HMG fire in return, resulting in another pile of bodies. The sun rises on a battlefield that looks like a Game of Thrones scene. There are a few dead idiots with guns, and a lot of dead unarmed people who just got too close to the real idiots. Some people live streamed the whole thing, their phones still broadcasting from their lifeless hands. We piss off the aliens and they take over the earth. I hope they start with every one of the haters in this thread. A boring event that in 10 years will be spun into a Hollywood action film that makes millions. News talking heads: although a plan was made to storm Area 51 on social media, government officials were able to confirm the raid did not take place and Area 51 was not breached. Local blurbs around the country: insert name, S family is seeking answers after, name, disappeared after making plans to visit Area 51. Alternatively, they all get flashy thinged and don't remember being there. I suspect that few people will actually show up for the raid. That being said, I would not be surprised if the government prepared for it nonetheless, and that the cost of such preparations would not be trivial. I would imagine that the government will bring in enough security and equipment to block access to the base by a large crowd, with an emphasis on avoiding anyone being injured. Along with that, they will probably also set up medical services to provide aid as needed. All of this will cost money, of course, but I don't think that the government would want to be entirely unprepared for the event. So imagine this: a handful of protesters show up to the event and find themselves there with a massive military security and possibly civilian law enforcement personnel, along with a complement of ambulances, paramedics, and EMTs. Make sure you subscribe to the channel and click that bell to turn on notifications, so you'll be sure to know when the next video comes out. Want to watch some more? Check out my other videos. I really do appreciate everyone who helps make these videos possible. And as always, thanks for watching.